What's poppin', y'all? It's your boy Maxwell here, and today we gonna do that new first listen of that that Trey Songz, Passion, Pain, and Pleasure. That shit just came out tonight, and you know what? We gonna listen to that shit. You know, let's get it poppin'. Let's go. Huh?
What are you doing?
What are you doing?
I was trying to record.
That's not gonna lie.
I was trying to record like you.
The hell are you?
Yo, man. Yo.
I'm about to quit.
Stop.
I'm tired of this job, man.
Alright, bye. Bye. Stupid, man.
Bye, y'all.
Okay, I don't know where the hell he just went, but you know you got your boy Daniel P here with another first listen. What's going on, humans? So we're here for another first listen that I think some of you know that I'm pretty excited for. That new Kid Cudi, Passion, Pain, and Demon Slayin. I've really been waiting for this album for a while, because earlier in the year I made a video about how he said he was going to make 2 albums this year. And apparently we're only getting 1, but that's all good. I'm not mad about it. His last album, Speed and Bullet to Heaven. Speed and Bullet to Heaven. Got that right here. Was, you know, obviously not what everybody wanted. I personally think it has some gems on it. It has some good songs. But again, not what I wanted to hear from him. But yeah, I just thought people should have gave him more of a chance. I mean, I understand if you don't like it, but don't just be like, this is trash from the first listen. Whatever. We're not here to get into that. We're here to listen to his new album, Passion, Passion Pam from Martin and Demon Slayin. No. I feel like Kid Cudi just changes up so much, I never know what to expect. Like that last album, I didn't know what to expect, but I kind of did at the same time. That's how I feel about this one. Again, in my last video, pretty much about Cudi, I put up a list of the songs, and in that list, it was cut up into different segments, a lot like the Man on the Moon stuff was. So maybe this is my theory, real quick. Maybe this is leading up to A Man on the Moon 3, and that was gonna be his second album this year. I don't wanna throw myself too far and say that, but maybe. That's all I'm saying. Yeah. So, let's get into it. Okay, so track number 1, we already heard. You guys already know how I feel about it, but I'm still gonna groove a little bit to it for y'all. Frequency. Let's hear it. Who's this? Thank you. Okay. Favorite part coming. Alright, you guys already know I like that song a lot. Okay, track number 2. First track that I have not heard yet. Swim in the Light. Let's hear it. Oh. Okay. What you gonna do with this beat, though?
Trying on the pain, but it'll never go.
Sorrow song, I already know.
Smarter, stronger, my niggas gon' make it through. What is the dope? I've been low enough. Calls from the dark.
What's good?
I got hope in my eyes, no help inside. I'm a swim in the light.
You know what that sound like? It sound like that band Fun. One of their songs. I was feeling that track actually. In the beginning I wasn't sure if I was gonna feel it, but I was. It's about kind of a, you know, you can't numb that pain, so you might as well, I guess he was saying at the end, might as well just kind of swim in the light, try to swim in the light, and, you know, don't try to run away from this pain that you're feeling. So I can't tell right now if this is going to be the depressing chapter, but we'll see. Track number 3, Releaser. Let's hear it. Feeling dark. Huh? Ooh. Sounds a little like Speeding Bullet? Is that French? Huh? Tell me what that's saying. It's French. Something French. I was actually strangely feeling that. It was like kind of like a, I don't know, it like pulled me in though, like at the beat and just the kind of like mystical kind of way he was using his voice, he coming in like kind of, the glory is blinding. And I don't know, I was strangely feeling it. I can't explain why I was feeling it, but it felt like a kind of like a little interlude. It wasn't really any rapping or any lyrics, for that matter. Just those little couple of lines he had. Glory is blinding. But so far I'm feeling it. Feel like it's getting me in a little kind of vibe. I honestly feel like that song's gonna be stuck in my head after this. I don't know, it's just something about it. It's just the vibe, bro. Track number 4, By Design, featuring Andre 3000, or Andre Benjamin. Your boy, the legend. So, he's been on, this is his third album that he's just featuring on this year. So, he's going hard right now with the features. So, let's hear it. Okay. What the? Ooh.
Opens us the dawn, I'm truly alive. The satellite sets a frame to illuminate this shaded place to leave. Come on with it, come
True. Fire. I honestly didn't know what to expect out of this collaboration, but that was pure fire. Like, that is a Cudi that either we haven't heard in a long time or a Cudi that we haven't heard, period, yet. And it was flames, man. And Andre 3000 just complimented this track so well. And, wow. That's by far my favorite track on this album so far. Wow, I really like that. Just basically telling you to be yourself, believe in yourself, don't second guess yourself. You're your own lifeline. Wow. I really like that song. As you can see, I really, really like that song. So let's move on before I fucking explode or something. Track number 5, I already heard. It was on a SoundCloud a little while back, so just gonna groove to it.
Sometimes I just don't know what to believe in. Man, I wanna disappear. I'm exposed and I am pure. Feel secure. Except you and I were all in. All in.
I'm so annoying, man.
Whatever happens.
End of Act 1. I have to keep looking at my phone to see what act we're on now. So this is Act 2, Prophecy.
I prophesy!
Track number 6, Illusion. Ill, capital ILL. And then the rest is illusion. Let's hear it. This should be pretty ill.
To the demons in my head, oh,
I'm a misery.
Hallucinate, I was about 13.
Let's go.
The darkness had me deceased.
Damn, this is good, man.
On my own. These illusions in my head, oh,
I know.
Age of 23,
let's go.
It's when I finally heard the frequency.
Trying to hit a frequency.
And I've been tuned in the lineup.
I heard that somewhere. Probably on a Snapchat. That's why I heard it. Heard it on his Instagram, that's why I heard it. That one clip he played. I like that. I really like that track too. I'm just seeming so surprised because honestly, I really didn't know what to expect from this, and I was, not to be negative, but I had high expectations for this, obviously, but I thought maybe he was going to try to mix some of those old songs. I mean, maybe it's too soon for me to say anything, but so far it's pretty damn good. I like it. I also really like the way that he was kind of like going through his ages and how he felt. You know, he said he was 13. He felt like he was trapped by the demons and they were diseasing his soul. And then at 23, he finally heard the frequency that helped him get through it and helped him find what his purpose was. So I'm thinking this is definitely a journey type situation here. And yeah, getting into it, man. Getting into it. And it's just really good music, man. Track number 7, Rose Golden. Not Rose Gold, Rose Golden. Featuring Willow Smith, which I was wrong about on the freaking Childish Gambino album reaction, but whatever. Let's hear it. Got cold, that's the only reason.
Oh, since I was young, been grooving to my drum. Ain't that many teachers showing me my potential. Felt like a failure, mama said you know better. You might understand the power I possess. The story of the chosen.
Come on, man.
The story of the chosen.
I really like that track as well. I haven't heard a bad track yet. What was I gonna say? You know, it's kind of like, so I guess that's what this prophecy chapter is about, or this act is about. It's about kind of trying to find that sign to get you to do exactly what you want to do. And I like the message behind it, you know? God had a plan. You know, no schools, nobody could tell him what his plan was. He had to look within to find it. And he said, I like that line, he says, stop judging a nigga, everybody groups their own drum or something like that. Which I like that. And y'all need to learn that lesson. Okay, we're on to track number 8. Already heard this track. This is one of the singles. Actually, I was gonna do a track listen. I listened to it in my car, but then, I don't know, it just didn't come out right and I didn't put it up. But anyway. Love this fucking song. So we gonna listen to it. And we gonna groove. And you gonna see it. Baptized in blood. In fire. Baptized in blood. Baptized in fire. Featuring Travis Scott. Let's hear it. I really love that song. I feel like it's you know, you gotta be cool. I feel like that song makes me feel cool when I listen to it. I'm like, first of all, you start off, you're looking around, easy. Somebody probably like, what the fuck? And you go into the song and they start vibing with you. But anyway, feeling that track, feeling Travis Scott's feature, feeling like he's like a fan like me. Travis Scott is an actual fan of Kid Cudi. So he's like a fan like me, but I don't make music like that. And he's saying to Kid Cudi, you know, I phoned home to the moon. Did you change your number or something? Because you ain't pick up. So you need to come back to the moon. That's another reason why I thought this was maybe leading up to A Man on the Moon 3. Because of this, I know it's weird, I know it's stupid because it's one song, but I don't know. He just said, you know, if and when you get this message, we need you back home. So maybe he's trying to call him back to the moon. We'll see. It's another prophecy here. So yeah, we'll see. We'll see. On to track number 9, Flight at First Sight, Advanced, featuring Pharrell Williams, another legend. So, should be flames. I mean, that track by design. All right, let me stop talking about it. Let's hear it. Oh, this sound Pharrell as fuck already. Sound like some Timbaland shit. That Justin Timberlake. Hey, you should tell me what's to look down. What's to have to tell me what's to look down? Come on, I'm living since I come on. Let's take off the seance. There's no cause to get lost. If you found in this honey, she cutting through it, through it, through it. Come on, ask no more. I knew it. It seemed to be strange. So I'm barricading the women. It's a given. I'm in heaven or Mars. Oh, yeah, now. Ha! Ha! Oh, it's so good. It's so good. Whoa. I like that song. I liked it. Definitely think that him and Pharrell should have been linked up and made something like this. This is definitely different. A different sound. I've never heard something like this from Cudi. And partly because he never linked up with Pharrell, and that's kind of a like Pharrell kind of sound, that beat. You could tell Pharrell made that. Only either Pharrell or I would believe that Timbaland maybe made that. Those are only two that kind of make beats like that and like do it well like that. So, wow. I really like that track. So, let's just keep on going. Haven't hit a snag yet, so let's see. Track number 10, Does It. Let's hear it. We're building up to something. You can depend on God, life, guillotine, James, and my enemies. See him in the ditch, see him out in the exit. Can't stand the hitting bitch, nigga. My eye, I took up in the road to get in the mojo, in the mode, get in my jeans, white teeth, and clean fitted. Folks, let me mind the map, I can hide the old summer, set the views and the lid, the rest unfold. Songs, these home voices, follow growth. Can't stop on the man with passion. These hoes don't distract the God. I am no clown, grown man laying the stones on the arms of my throne, my kingdom, torn from space. Fuck off expression on pace. This is the case, I am a fighter. Drop the beat on me again, but he played me. I don't know how many times I'm gonna keep saying this, but I definitely felt that track pretty much stunting on these people. It's like kind of not feeling him, kind of feeling like he's not doing his thing, but he does it. He's doing all these, doing these movies, doing these shows. How you hating on him? Unfuckwittable with two T's. Next track, man. Don't fuck with me. Okay, we're on to the third act. Should I try to say this?
No, nigga! Smack dab in the
middle! Track 11, Dance for Eternity. Let's hear it. Oh, this is gonna be a dance track. Better make it good. It's gonna be a love one. Amore.
This is awesome. I wanna dance with you for eternity. Sure like to see that body wet.
Oh yeah.
What a pleasure, so much pleasure.
I was feeling that track. I didn't think I was gonna feel it in the beginning, just like I said about that earlier track. I didn't think I was gonna feel it. I thought it was gonna be kind of like a poppy song, which is not a problem, but you know, like overly poppy, you know what I'm saying? I felt like it was gonna be that, which I have no problem with pop before you guys start tearing me up, but I just thought it was gonna be like one of those kind of clubby pop songs, but it wasn't. He honestly brought his little kind of ghostly depressing voice onto it, and then the kind of little extra beat that was in the back was really good to not make it sound too trying to get on the radio in the club type situation. So yeah, I like that track. Obviously this is gonna be the love act, because he's saying that you know, this girl's so awesome, you can trust her, and that's hard to find, and he wants to dance with her for eternity. These girls be trying to get danced with for eternity, man. Okay, we're on to track number 12, Distant Fantasies. Let's hear it. Is this gonna be like Balmain Jeans, sex track or something? It's way darker this time? You sound extra dark. Ain't no damn sex track. That's why it's dark. Front for that new nigga, right?
I know you still think about me. I can tell he knows he probably saw it. No more dodging the shadows, ready to pounce.
Oh, man.
The yearning for my return. Laying next to him, you daydreaming on my meat. And you remember when I said, put it on my face. Damn, girl, when you learn, no escaping me.
This nigga said, you daydreaming on my meat.
No soul without your mate. Relate. Man, though I don't care how it happened.
Hey.
It's cool now, cause I know I'm sloppy as sex. The best way we both give and dawn. Until the break of dawn, I got it. I get you.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you know I'm the only one to get your red lips. Spread it up and pound it till it's numb. Yum. And then you can play
the game. Yeah, getting crazy.
Like, what's on your mind, babe? When big and you caught line.
Oh, man.
Tiny to everyone. Distant yearnings and fantasies. Keep lying.
Wow, I was really feeling that track. Pretty much trying to call his ex out. Like, you know this new dude you with is whack as hell, and you know you miss my touch, you know you yearning for me, and you're lying entirely to everyone. And wow, I really like what Cudi did with this track. This is the Cudi we want to hear, man. This is what we want to hear. Even though it's cool, it's cool that you want to do all that rock stuff, and I mean, the rock stuff's not that bad. If you have an open mind and you allow yourself to listen to it, it's not that bad. But honestly, this is what he is really good at. His voice is like made for songs like this and songs like we've heard already. His voice is made for that kind of beat for me. To me, at least, you know? Track number 13, Wounds. Let's hear it. That track, obviously it's a kind of a track, kind of like sewing your wounds, you know, fixing your, all your scars, all these scars that life has put on you, you know, you're gonna sew them yourself, you don't need nobody else to fill that void that you got, you're gonna fix it yourself, pretty much, and don't worry about why these things happen, I guess he was trying to say. Kind of just sew your wounds up and just keep on moving. Good track. Track number 14, Mother Nature. Let's hear it. I wonder what this is going to be. Some mystic ass beats. I said Mother Nature, I meant to say mature nature. The hell is wrong with me? Wicked. Okay, cool little interlude type feel. I don't know if this is supposed to be like them getting it in or something. Because it's called Mature Nature, that's kind of the only reason I'm saying that. Also, he says, I trust you and trust that you trust me. I don't know. Just made me feel like that was what was going on. And I could be wrong, probably wrong. Y'all probably about to tear me up, but it's all good. Cool little ass. Track number 15, Kitchen. Let's hear it. Thank you.
songs, man.
I was feeling that track too. I know I keep saying I'm feeling it, but these, I'm just feeling them. I'm not gonna lie to you guys. I'm gonna tell you if I think it's but. Honestly, I'm feeling these tracks. So I'm feeling this track as well. Nice little love track, obviously, on this part. This final track of that part, you know, about love. You know, you can't take the heat of his love. Stand the fuck out the kitchen. What is you doing, B? But, no. If you can't take the heat of his love, stay out the kitchen. And I know that part is going to be stuck in my head, even though I don't know what he's saying. Say, what song, love, I know. I don't know what he's saying, but it's just, I feel like it's going to be stuck in my head. Whatever. Okay, we're on to Act 4.
Oh my god. Oh my god, he on X Games mode.
It's bright and heaven is warm. That's kind of a play on that DMX album. It's dark and hell is hot, I think is the name of it, right? It's dark and hell is hot. This is Act 4. And it's track 16 to 18, carrying us to the end of this album. Let's hear track number 16, Cosmic Warrior. Let's hear it. Sounding cosmic as fuck. Already.
Since birth it was prophecy, cosmic warrior. Surrounded by infinite light. Surrounded by infinite light. Let you know. Let you know.
Like that bird screech in the back. How you do the harp, right? Okay, that track was pretty good, but I feel like that was my least favorite. It was still a good track, but I don't know. Just didn't really care about it as much as the other ones. Just my opinion. This is track number 17, The Guide. Featuring Andre Benjamin again. This is two features from both. So this is Andre Benjamin, Andre 3 Stacks, Andre 3000, whatever you want to call him, The Guide. Keep walking. Sounds ominous.
Make such sounds, it never would occur to people her up downs. Convertible would murder evil pup hounds. Just been dogging her, courtesy and real love found. Just been dodging her, Mr. Man misogyny hands been massaging her. If she ran and blew up a town, should I would part in her, put a part in her steps.
See me on the medic with the passion when we make love. Never made it to the bed, sex in the living room floor.
Good track. Again, with Under 3000 on it, they both killed it. Talking about this girl that kind of just gets whatever she wants. Gets whatever she wants from a man, pretty much. They both killed it. The production on this track and the whole album is just really good. I don't know who's helping out with production, but they're killing it. Yeah, good track. Almost done. Okay, we're on to track number 18, The Commander. Let's hear it. He kind of slipped this one on there, too, because on this list I got here, it doesn't have this song. It only has 18 tracks, so he put this one on there, I guess, last minute a little bit. So, let's hear it. Another stellar, interstellar type sound. Oh, man, yo, this is fucking great, man. I know I heard it earlier. Is probably one of my favorite tracks on the album right now. Pretty much summing up this whole album, you know, kind of feeling like he was lost in the beginning. I heard some lyrics that I heard, I think, in that first act. I think he said you're blinded by the light. I think I heard that in the first few tracks. So he's kind of going back to that, and obviously going back to that heart of a lion with the no. And I don't know if he purposely used the dun-dun-dun-dun kind of that you hear in the beginning from Dat Nunu. But I don't know if he purposely did that. I just hear it. But yeah, probably one of my favorites on there, kind of just bringing it all together and letting himself know you're the commander. You're the one that's been in control of your life this whole time. And, you know, now you can see your own glory, kind of, is what he's saying. So, one of my favorites on the album, and that's a perfect final track, but obviously they put Surfing on there. Still a good track, so we heard it. Well, at least I heard it. You probably have heard it. Still a good closer, so let's groove to it. Surfing, featuring Sherelle. Featuring Pharrell. Pharrell, let's hear it.
Been told y'all this is cinema. I am on my Kubrick horn like a Spielberg, close to kind of fall. Feeling awesome to be back in the making of competition. Making what I want, that's a flex. You can't do what you want, I ain't got a bitch. My palms, let them go down with them humps.
Okay, so you guys already know how I feel about the track, so I can move on to how I feel about the album as a whole. Bravo. Oh, definitely love this album, man. I honestly thought I was gonna hit a snag at least one point in this album, but honestly, I really, really liked every song. Except for that, I said that song Cosmic Warrior would probably be my least favorite, but it was still a good song. Like, it's not like it was a terrible song. I was like, nah, I can't listen to it. But good job, Kid Cudi. I haven't been excited about a Kid Cudi album like this in a while. I just feel like I just haven't felt that genuine excitement like that. Like, honestly, there's been tracks that I like. There's been songs I like on his other, on his stuff before this, obviously. But I just really loved tracks on this one. Features did a really good job. Andre 3000, them two on a track is just gold. Just good. Just, they should make an album together. Pharrell, Willow Smith, Travis Scott, fire. This was just fire. This album was fire, man. Honestly, it might surpass Indicud here. I think it might surpass Indicud. You know, obviously, I'm gonna listen to it more than one time before I make my decision. But let's put a poll. Do you guys think this is better than Indicud? Put a poll there. I'll put a poll there just to put a poll. See what you guys say. But I really like this album. Flames, man. I need the physical copy though. I definitely need the physical copy. Need to put that poster. It's probably gonna come in a poster. All of his albums come in a poster. Put that out, that poster right there. I feel like I'm forgetting to say something. That's why I'm just talking so much. Oh, I was gonna say, this was kind of a mixture of like old Cudi. You heard some of old Cudi in there, and then you heard something you've never heard from Cudi before in there. And you've heard like pretty much all the Cudis in this. And I feel like I heard a little bit of Speed and Bullet to Heaven in there. A little bit. Like a little pinch. Perfect amount. This was just a good album. Tell me what you guys think about my theory that maybe this is leading into Man on the Moon. Honestly, I don't know. I'm always wrong. Every time I make a theory or something, I'm wrong. But tell me what you guys think of that. Vote on the poll, and thank you guys for watching. I'm gonna go do some fucking schoolwork. Probably write mad papers. I don't know when this is gonna go up, actually. Hopefully not too late, but I gotta do some schoolwork before it goes up, y'all. Don't rush me. I'm out of here, man. See y'all next week or something. Whatever comes out. Peace.